Do cortisone injections help heal plantar fasciitis more quickly, or are they killing your recovery? Don't even think about getting a cortisone shot for plantar fasciitis before watching this video. I'm Dr. AJ Ludlow with Stronglife Physiotherapy, and I've got some information you need to hear before deciding whether or not to get a cortisone shot for plantar fasciitis. We like the idea that something simple and quick like a cortisone shot can fix us, but what is this stuff they're injecting into your foot, and does it even help? Cortisone is a drug used to reduce inflammation. It does this by suppressing or hindering the immune system. It's considered a steroid. When someone says they're getting a steroid shot, it's usually cortisone. This is not to be confused with the steroids that are taken to build muscle and strength more quickly. Those are anabolic steroids. Anabolic means building up. Cortisone is a very different type of steroid and has the exact opposite effect. Cortisone causes tissues to break down. Part of how cortisone works is by stopping the production of collagen. Collagen is what is used by our body to heal, and it is what the plantar fascia is made of. Some people think that because a cortisone injection reduces pain, that it must be helping it heal too. Well, this is not true. Cortisone does nothing to help the body heal. In fact, it actually slows down the healing process. So cortisone helps reduce inflammation, but if you've seen my other videos, you already know that there is no inflammation in plantar fasciitis after a few weeks. The fascia is breaking down and having a hard time healing, but inflammation is not part of this process, so it doesn't make sense to inject cortisone into the foot for plantar fasciitis. What does the research say? Well, one interesting study had 82 people with plantar fasciitis. Half got a steroid shot and half got a saline or mild saltwater solution shot, which was supposed to be a placebo that does nothing. The steroid group only did a little better than the placebo group. In fact, only 1 in 3 people had enough relief from their pain to be considered a successful outcome. The mild pain relief that these people had only lasted about a month, and the pain returned. There are risks to having steroid injections. They actually cause the injected area to become weaker and to break down more. The fascia is already breaking down or degenerating and having a hard time healing, so you will have a higher risk of rupturing or tearing the plantar fascia, especially if you are very active and especially if you get multiple injections. When the fascia tears, it is very painful, worse than plantar fasciitis, and it permanently changes the structure of your foot, which can lead to other problems down the road. Experts believe the risk of the fascia tearing is 10% or maybe even higher in those that have multiple injections. A 10% chance, or 1 in 10, seems like too high of a risk for something that doesn't help you heal, only provides temporary relief, if any, and may actually make you worse in the long run. Oh, and one more thing, cortisone can permanently dissolve the cushion in your heel. The cushioning on the bottom of your heel is provided by a protective layer of fat. That means you will have less cushion with every step for the rest of your life. This makes it harder to heal from plantar fasciitis and makes you more likely to get it again in the future. It's your decision whether or not to get a cortisone shot, but now you have more information to make a smart choice. I do not recommend them. I do recommend that you spend your time and money on things that actually help plantar fasciitis heal, like the stretches and exercises I teach in my other videos and in the Heal Strong system. Click the link in the description below to get a free gift that will feel amazing on your heels without all the risks and side effects of an injection.